Hachette Audio presents an RDA Press audio production of Summit Leadership by Blair Singer, read by Blair Singer, with foreword by Robert Kiyosaki, read by Garrett Sutton.
Foreword by Robert Kiyosaki. What is leadership? Leadership is power, and a simple definition of power is the ability to do. That definition describes my longtime friend Blair Singer. Blair has the unreal ability and the power to inspire others to do the impossible, to go beyond their personal limitations, thoughts, and beliefs, to climb to the top of Kilimanjaro. But life is not about making it to the top of Kilimanjaro. Kilimanjaro is outside of us. Life is about summiting and conquering the peaks of Kilimanjaro inside of us, those daunting and seemingly insurmountable challenges and obstacles that life throws at us on a daily basis. That is Blair's amazing ability and where his genius shines. When Blair leads everyday people, people like you and me, to the top of Kilimanjaro, he is inspiring each of us, ordinary people, to first be leaders of ourselves, leaders in our personal lives, before we can lead others. In their book, The Fourth Turning, 1998, A Book of Prophecy, authors William Strauss and Neil Howe warn of the fourth turning, a period in which we find ourselves today, in 2022. Strauss and Howe emphasize that the fourth turning will be a period marked by weak leaders. Observing the news of the past few years, the United States of America is turning into the divided states of America, with the burning of cities, looting sprees, a humiliating retreat from Afghanistan, open border invasions, mass migrations, workers refusing to be vaccinated in the face of government mandates, and on. Do we need more proof that the world is in a fourth turning and that it is a leaderless world? Blair Singer's book, Summit Leadership, is the complement to the fourth turning. In a world of weak leaders, it is more important than ever that we draw all we can from Blair's lifetime of study, real life experience, and his wisdom on the subject of leadership. Increasing your personal leadership skills may be your most important investment during this time in history. Always remember, leadership is power, and your most important power is your ability to lead yourself before you lead others. Robert Kiyosaki.
Introduction. Life is full of lessons. The universe throws challenges, obstacles, and rewards your way constantly, as if there were some predetermined life curricula of study you're supposed to take and master. Only you have no syllabus to follow, no agenda, no list of assignments to be completed. You may find yourself flying by the seat of your pants hoping for an A, but winding up with a C, D, or an F more often than not. Then it's back to life's classroom. I have often wondered why we get the set of lessons that we get. It's like we become magnets for a certain set of lessons, almost like a fatal attraction. But why? What I do know is if you don't learn the lesson being presented to you, you will be forced to deal with it again and again at an ever-increasing intensity until you finally get it. Unfortunately, by the time you start to master some of life's lessons, your time is already counting down. Your lessons will come from every area of your life: your health, your family, your kids, your friends, your business, your teams. As you're a student of life, so is everyone else. Sometimes the lessons will be the same, but the timing will be different. Sometimes the lessons themselves will be different. Think of it as being in a one-room schoolhouse where everyone is learning at their own level and pace. And if the whole of your experiences is like a school, the good news is that you have teachers to fall back on. And the better news is that you are also the teacher to others who have yet to learn the lessons that you've mastered. I firmly believe our purpose as leaders is to do just that. It's to master the lessons and then pass that knowledge on to others so they might accelerate their own learning journeys. That as each generation of business leaders, community leaders, thought leaders, spiritual leaders, health, wealth, and happiness leaders learn through trial and error, we empower those on our teams and within our circles of influence to reach even higher levels of achievement, growth, and happiness. A remarkable person I met years ago, whom I consider a great teacher, his name is Po Chung. He is the co-founder of DHL International. One day in his Hong Kong office, we discussed the importance of leaders being teachers. I feel he hit the nail on the head when he said, quote, "It is a business leader's societal responsibility to teach whatever they have learned in their careers to others," end quote. This is what moves our civilization and species ahead. I've committed this part of my career and life to training the best teachers and leaders in the world to expedite the transfer of knowledge and fundamentally change the way we learn and grow, particularly in the marketplace. In 2012, I had a unique opportunity to travel to Africa with my then 16-year-old son, Ben, and climb Mount Kilimanjaro. I've been back 8 times since. I didn't go there expecting to learn leadership lessons, but that's exactly what happened. Each trip up the mountain taught me something unique and transformative about true leadership. This doesn't happen for everyone, but it happened to me. And it happens for those I take up the mountain each year because I had excellent teachers in our mountain guides, Kevin Chirilla and Kristen Sanquist of K2 Adventure Travel. Those first few years of climbing with them, I'm not even sure they knew how valuable their lessons were. The 13-day trip to Africa and the top of Kilimanjaro is one of the most exquisite, intense, and profound microcosms of a person's life. The trek up the mountain forces you out of complacency, out of the hypnotic rhythm of everyday life, and makes you acutely aware of everything around you. The weather, your physicality, even your mental state can change in a heartbeat. You must make decisions and adapt quickly or you fail. The lessons of leadership come fast and furious. They are embedded in every step and every breath and every connection with your fellow hikers, with nature, with your inner being. So much so that the only guarantee I give to those who trek there with my team is that the person who comes off that mountain will be the biggest and best version of themselves. As leaders, we all have mountains to climb in our business and our personal lives. And while you may not be able to ascend to a physical summit and back, you can still reap the benefits of the lessons from Kilimanjaro. You can kick it up a notch. You can become acutely aware. You can come full circle from being a learner to being a teacher and bettering your team. That's why I decided to write this book, to share the leadership lessons I've learned on the mountain with all of you who are ready to tackle your summit, whatever that might be. At present, we are locked in a global crisis that includes a pandemic, economic collapse, and the possible restructuring of how humanity will live its life. These are our Kilimanjaros. This period will be remembered for good and bad for many generations to come. The biggest lesson the future will look back upon is what kind of leadership emerged or did not emerge during these times. I feel blessed to be living at this amazing juncture in the history of humankind. The future will determine how well we led, how well we raised our families, how well we built and supported our teams and communities, how courageously we continue to love, connect, teach, and learn the lessons that have been provided to us. One of my mentors said it well, "Crisis is change trying to come forth." A crisis appears because the invitations to make changes are ignored or pushed down the road for convenience, comfort, or ignorance. We are in a crisis, and now change has demanded our attention. It is my hope and intention that the lessons of leadership at 19,341 feet, that's about 5,900 meters on Kilimanjaro, inspire you to make the right calls, do the right things, and lead your families, teams, and communities to new heights of success and fulfillment, not just for you, but for all of us. I found my answer to why you seem to have a fatal attraction to a certain set of lessons. It's because you're a leader. That's it. And your job is to use those lessons to serve the greatest number of people you can. It's because it's in your DNA. You are supposed to lead. You've known it for a long time. You may have been reluctant or afraid to admit it, but you would not be reading this if something didn't pull you toward it. Whether it's Kilimanjaro, COVID-19, economic turmoil, or raising your family, here are the lessons that will be the mountain guide for reaching your and your team's summit. Lead with knowledge, lead with courage, and lead with inspiration. Blair. Chapter 1, Leadership at 18,652 feet. Only those who will risk going too far can possibly find out how far they can go. T.S. Eliot. July 11, 2019. Stella Point, Kilimanjaro. 18,652 feet above sea level, just below the summit. The mountain climbing guide's eyes widen and convey a message I don't want to hear. Through the howling wind, her words ring crystal clear. You gotta go down the mountain now, Kristen commands. Go now! Her pulse oximeter shows my blood oxygen level has begun to drop precipitously. Dangerous. When that happens, climbers are rapidly sent back down the mountain to a lower elevation where their lungs can draw more oxygen. If I don't get down quickly, my lungs and brain could fill with fluid, edema, unconsciousness. Even death could occur. Yet, I don't feel that bad right now. I feel like I can make it to the summit, which is less than 700 feet up. But I know the rules. Kristen is the guide, the leader. Her word is law. If I disobey her, I may jeopardize not only my life, but my teammates' lives as well. I'm thinking, shit. I've successfully climbed this mountain 8 times before. Why is this happening now? And what am I going to do with this banner? The banner I'm holding is supposed to be unfurled at the summit. It's a tradition for climbs I organize. Suddenly, my brain goes quiet. Everything goes into slow motion. I know what I have to do, and every second counts. I quickly survey our 30 climbers and toss the banner to Pau, a bright young Malaysian woman who teaches meditation. I've got to go, I say to her, not having time to explain. My head now feels like a balloon, and my vision is distorted. Kristen was right. I need to go down, fast. I follow Ali, one of our amazing Tanzania porters, who breaks into a full run down the mountain. He's carrying my backpack and presumably would carry me should I collapse. Ali, with his deeply scarred face and beaming smile, is a pleasure to be around, even though he speaks very little English. He comes from a meager background and spends his entire year scraping together what money he can for the high season of climbing where he can...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.